What this demonstration does is show a contrast between a healthy soil with a good plant-soil relationship and a soil that's probably less than healthy because it's just been plowed, it's just been seeded, but it doesn't have the plant cover, the plant root interaction. So we're going to go ahead and simulate rain here, and it's going to show two things. It's going to show runoff, the differences in runoff from the plants with no plants, and then it's going to show infiltration. And we'll see if there's a difference. So we'll go ahead and add some rain. Okay, so what we're seeing is, and it's obvious on this side, we have a dirtier water. Why? Because we've had soil runoff. We've had runoff from a surface that has no cover, no protection from rain. So it's going to carry with it some sediment runoff. Over here, for runoff, we do have, and this is a lot more to do with this type of plant. It's a permanent pasture that's been irrigated, and it's a blue gramma, so it's a very tight pasture. So infiltration would not be as much on this as it would be, say, on an annual crop or maybe on rangeland. So we do have runoff, but if you'll notice, the runoff is clean. Now, the second thing to note is this, we have some infiltration. We have water and it's actually pretty clean. It's infiltrated down to the soil, and that's a property of the soil that shows that it's healthy. It can allow water to infiltrate. It's not sealed off. If you notice over here, we have very little to no infiltration. And that's because when the soil's disturbed, the soil is not well aggregated, and then it does not allow for infiltration. In as much as when you have plant soil, plant roots help the soil aggregate. So today we've looked at infiltration and runoff. And again, this is a small window into the importance of soil health. Soil health is showing the importance of soil plant relationships and how the interactions affect both runoff and infiltration.